Greetings, Guardians. My name is Bai from RFN. Today we're going to be discussing some supposed leaks and rumors about Destiny's DLC and three upcoming new subclasses that may appear in the game. Now, this is from Reddit, not the most reliable source in the world, but also something that's turned up things that have turned out to be true in the past anyway. So let's just take it for what it is. There is quite a lot of detail here though, so maybe this is true, maybe it's not. There's also a tiny bit of information in this particular post about the hive raid known as Crota's End. So without any further ado, let's jump in with the first new subclass that supposedly we'll be getting for the Titan. And this is known as the Crusader subclass, and its super is known as Purge. Now in Purge, you'll shoot a giant horizontal column of light directly in front of you. And the upgrades that you can get thicken the cylinder the column makes up, which, generally speaking, in the default is the size of a Guardian, but you can upgrade it to be about 200% larger in size. You can also upgrade it supposedly to have the column shoot through walls, and you can even have the column shoot a second column behind you as well. So technically this is kind of an interesting one. It's got a very long reach for a Titan, as far as I can see. But it's just, generally speaking, an interesting idea to play around with a super that targets such a specific area. It's not really been done before, but at the same time, I mean, I guess it's practically the same idea as Golden Gun. It sounds a little bit weak if it's as small as I think it is. So maybe it isn't the case that it's like this, maybe it is, but we'll find out. And supposedly the grenades that this subclass gets are that it throws three small fire grenades at once, pretty much like the Shatter perk on a Warlock's Nova Bomb. You can drop a grenade behind you, and this is supposedly designed for escape tactics while you're being chased. And then you have a self-planted grenade, and the button activates the grenade for 8 seconds. Any melee damage taken in the time you have the grenade active for will set the grenade off. It barely doesn't kill a Guardian by itself, so yeah, take that for what you will. It is a very close kill, but it's designed to help you win those sort of melee fights. Next up is the Warlock, and for this, the Warlock has an Arc subclass known as Arc Thrower. Not a very original name, and this is another reason why I don't know if I can truly judge whether this is a legit post, but the super's name supposedly is known as Jupiter Storm, and this creates an orb about the size of a servitor slightly above you and in front of you. And basically what the orb does is it floats in the air and shoots lightning out at anything that it comes near. Now, the thing about this is you can increase the range of the lightning strikes that you get, and you can even cause chain lightning, or you can cause orbs to spawn further away from the player character. I think the super is kind of locks Warlocks into their role of zone control. There's not really much interesting stuff here, and again, I don't know how powerful this would be. If the lightning is a one-hit kill, then maybe this would be fantastic, given that you could go in there, slam it down on a territory or a control point, and then you can immediately clear it. Again, if it's got chain lightning, that could be very powerful, but it depends on how much damage the lightning does. If it's a one-hit kill, I'd say this is probably one of the better supers out there in PvP, especially in game modes that result on team clumping and whatnot. But otherwise, I think it might be kind of weak. It also does depend on how quickly the lightning strikes, but we'll see. The grenades that you supposedly get for this Warlock are an arc grenade that detonates with a second button input, which is very interesting. I'm not sure how long this would last, but supposedly it's going to last until you put the second button input down. Of course, this is nice because it means that not only could you throw it on a wall in front of you and then run past it and allow someone to walk by it and then detonate, but there's a lot of other tricky little things you could do. I think this is actually a very good grenade for a Warlock. An accurate hand with this means that you can actually go ahead and throw this down, catch several opponents out, and generally speaking it works similar to the sort of grenade that drops behind the Titan, discussed in the Purge Crusader build. So you could basically use this as a sort of escape tactic, you know, you could wait for the person to chase you and then you could go ahead and do it. Next up, there is a grenade that transfers health to the Warlock. This is a very interesting grenade, and the reason why I think this will be powerful is because of the marginal situations where you are down on health, and you have just enough time to stick a grenade somewhere in the vicinity of the Guardian that's attacking you. This is an equalizer. This basically is a way of saving yourself from fights, and I think it will be quite powerful, assuming you can follow it up with random fire. Because at this point, let's say that you have 25% of your health left, and the other player has, say, 75% of theirs, maybe 100. This grenade evens that out. It means that the fight is basically reset, and sure, maybe at the end of the day with high Warlock recovery this also helps, but I feel like this grenade has a lot of good synergy, generally speaking, with the high recovery of Warlocks. And finally, The really zone-controlling type grenade that you'll get for this class is known as the fence grenade, which creates a small electrified fence. It sticks to walls like the lightning grenade of Titans, but it lasts about half as long. And if this is not zone control, then I have no idea what this would be. But to be quite frank, I think that it is a fantastic idea. Very inventive grenades, if these are completely legit. Finally, hunters have the Trapper subclass, and this is their Void subclass with the Super Void Well. Now, unlike the other supers that you'll get with the Hunter, the Void Well doesn't look like it kills anyone. The Void Well basically is just something you place on the floor, and enemies inside the Void Well cannot jump, and they have reduced movement speed. And you can also upgrade it so that you reduce all enemy movement, you can prevent enemies from using abilities, or you can increase the radius of the Void Well. Now, this is a very powerful super in PvE. PvP, I would think that you would basically use this to sort of secure the map. It's a much more subtle super, and it's basically a hunter's only form of zone control, really. I mean, if you look at it, if you placed a Void Well down on the main approach path to, say, an objective, and if that lasted a very long time, I can see why this would be powerful. Because the Void Well basically prevents enemy movement from one area to another, which means that you can lock down one single path quite effectively. The grenades that you get for this, however, are much more interesting. You get a generic void damage grenade. It doesn't bounce, but it sticks to any surface, meaning that if it sticks to a player, it will be a one-hit kill. You get a bolus that acts as a sticky but does minimal damage, while greatly reducing the target's movement speed and preventing them from jumping. So that again, it runs in this kind of very strong PvE class where you can debuff all your enemies, but at the same time, is this strong in PvP? Hell no. I think that this looks like the Sunsinger, where in PvE there's a lot of options that you get and you can fiddle around with, but generally speaking, in PvP, it's not the case. Finally, you get caltrops. And basically, what you do with these is you throw them on the ground. They're like little mines. They're not very easy to see, and there's a large amount of them for every grenade charge. But stepping on one detonates it and means a small amount of damage is given to the player that steps on it. One grenade can kill a guardian, and there will be a few caltrops left over, so this would be very interesting. I feel like this would probably be the PvP choice, if I'm going to be 100% honest. Caltrops feel like they are something that could be very cheap, but at the same time, some of it could be very useful. As far as zone control goes, I think they're very good. The additional information provided about the Hive Raid is that it's apparently pretty fun. And from what I've tested, says the person who supposedly tested it, the first boss is much more enjoyable than either of the boss fights in the Vault of Glass. Given how complicated the Aethyon fight is and how, and just generally speaking, how satisfying it is to finish that challenge, this makes me kind of excited. There's also a point in this where he says that there is a sequence where all the guardians will want to be on their sparrows, trying to outrun a giant ogre. He also notes that some of the wizards will have different attacks instead of the bombardment from Darkness Blast, which means that they're generally speaking more interesting to fight and they're less of a pain. Again, we don't know whether all of this is true or not, but to be quite frank, I think that this, if it is going to be true, means that there is a lot of interesting stuff coming up in Crota's End, not to mention the update. The DLC could be much more substantial than we thought, which would be, to be quite frank, pretty awesome. Anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed that. My name has been Mine was Bife, per Ardacia ad Astra. I'll see you Starside.
Heavy ammo on the way. Heavy ammo available. the true meaning of war.